Ladies and gentlemen, the last speaker of day one is Professor Abhay Keshav Dev Pandey. He's a senior consultant interventional cardiologist at the Al Zahra Hospital from Dubai, United Arab Emirates. And for the next 11 minutes, Professor Pandey would speak on PCI for the non-culprit artery in semi. Professor Pandey.
Good evening. Greetings from Al Zahra Hospital, Sharjah, and from the Cardiological Society of India, Emirates chapter. In 2002, when I went to Sharjah, we started coronary angioplasty, and I was only one. And now we have more than 50 members of the Cardiological Society of India, Emirates chapter. Contribution of us was to start primary angioplasty and intervention in private sector in United Arab Emirates. And we are proud to say that in last 14 years, in my center, the primary angioplasty has been the first treatment of choice, and we have not thrombolized a single patient. The primary angioplasty is the to establish the TIMI-3 flow to the culprit vessel, to remove the culprit vessel obstruction and to achieve the myocardial perfusion in timely manner is the accepted treatment of the STEMI patient all over the world. However, the problem that we always face, we started doing primary angioplasty, and every person who does primary angioplasty faces a very important question, and which is what I'm going to address today, is the angioplasty of the non-culprit vessel at the time of the primary angioplasty. 30 to 50% of the STEMI patient, the ST elevation myocardial infarction patient, have additional stenosis other than the infarct-related artery. And the current guidelines, even current guidelines today, advocate only the culprit vessel angioplasty. However, there are two important studies which have come recently, and the practices in most of the centers have suggested to do angioplasty of the non-culprit vessels. Most of the STEMI patient, as I already elaborated, have 40 to 65% of the lesion which are not responsible for the myocardial infarction, but are associated with increased risk of adverse cardiovascular events. The optimal revascularization strategy remains unclear with outcomes of various randomized and observational studies that are conflicting. Why we should not do non-culprit vessel angioplasty at the time of the primary angioplasty? Because every PCI carries an additional finite risk. The non-culprit lesion severity is often exaggerated during acute myocardial infarction. There is an enhanced thrombotic and inflammatory state which persists sometimes after acute myocardial infarction, leading to more complication, possibility of more complication. The procedure becomes longer, and there could be a danger of contrast nephropathy, hemodynamic instability. Additional time is required. Your procedure time is increased. There is more radiation to the operator and additional cost of the procedure. These are the things which are the points which are against performing non-culprit vessel angioplasty. The ischemic complication may also lead to severe hemodynamic compromise, and there is already myocardial dysfunction secondary to the damage of the culprit vessel obstruction. Therefore, the complications could be more. There is a risk of ischemic complication in every PCI because of the generalized inflammatory condition. The risk of transformation of the culprit vessel during hospitalization is extremely low. If you have an additional lesion, you are already giving a lot of antiplatelet agents, and the possibility of a non-culprit lesion becoming culprit is low. Therefore, our guidelines based advocated that we should not do a non-culprit vessel PCI. I have already elaborated on these two points, that is contrast nephropathy and this. And another point is that the non-culprit lesion may not be associated with the future events. What are the points in favor of performing a non-culprit PCI? It improves hemodynamics. The hypercontraction of the non-infarct territory is especially important in patients with cardiogenic shock. It prevents reinfarction. and patient is already receiving aggressive antithrombotic therapy. Therefore, we can prevent the complication, and also there is a decreased need of repeat revascularization. What the guidelines stated, because of the earlier experience, the guidelines stated, the European guidelines stated that the primary PCI should be limited to culprit vessel with the exception of the cardiogenic shock and persistent ischemia after the PCI of a supposed culprit lesion. And this was a class 2A indication, and stage revascularization of non-culprit vessel in the same hospitalization or after this in case of persistent ischemia was also class 2A indication. However, American guidelines were very, very particular, and the non-culprit vessel angioplasty at the time of the primary PCI was class 3B indication. That means it was contraindicated to do, as per the American guidelines, the non-culprit vessel angioplasty is contraindicated. And the other guidelines are PCI is indicated in non-infarct related artery at a time separate from primary PCI in patients who have spontaneous symptoms of myocardial ischemia. This is class 1C indication, and PCI is reasonable in non-infarct artery at a time separate from primary PCI in patient with intermediate or high risk finding on non-invasive testing. So these were the guidelines. However, the whole situation changed with two major trials which have come recently in 2013 and 2014. That was the randomized trial of preventive angioplasty in myocardial infarction, or PAMI trial. In this particular trial, this patients with acute ST elevation myocardial infarction were randomly assigned to undergo an infarct vessel angioplasty versus preventive PCI, and the rate of primary outcome of the of cardiac death, myocardial infarction, refractory angina was studied and was found to be lower in preventive PCI. If we see here that the death of the patient who were randomized to a preventive PCI were significantly lower with a p-value of 0.001. So all the parameters in PAMI trial, the death from the cardiac causes, non-fatal myocardial infarction, refractory angina, non-fatal myocardial infarction, refractory angina, all are less in this particular trial, and this is an evidence in favor of doing a non-culprit vessel angioplasty at the time of the primary PCI for STEMI. This particular graph shows that there is a 65% reduction in cardiac death, non-fatal MI and refractory angina, which in today's era of evidence-based medicine is an important pointer for us to do a non-culprit vessel angioplasty. So the conclusions from the PAMI trial were that in patients with STEMI and multivessel coronary artery disease undergoing infarct PCI, preventive PCI in non-infarct coronary arteries with major stenosis significantly reduces the risk of adverse cardiovascular event as compared to the patient who have undergone only culprit vessel angioplasty. Similar results were obtained from the culprit trial, where the total mortality, recurrent myocardial infarction, heart failure, and revascularization were significantly less in patients who underwent complete revascularization at the time of the STEMI. The green bar shows the reduction in all these particular parameters favoring the angioplasty of the non-culprit vessel. If we do the comparison of all the meta-analysis of all the trials, which has where we have compared patients who have undergone infarct-related culprit vessel angioplasty versus multivessel PCI, the major studies from with DiMario, Polti, and Waldo, all of them have significantly shown reduction in cardiovascular mortality, which can be seen that all these parameters favors a multivessel PCI. Similarly, repetitive vascularization is less in patients who undergo in this meta-analysis who undergo a preventive PCI. So is the case with non-fatal myocardial infarction. And therefore, in conclusion, Today we have evidence from the two major trials and with meta-analysis that revascularization of the non-culprit lesion in addition to the culprit vessel angioplasty is associated with reduced cardiovascular mortality rate and repeat PCI, and therefore is the treatment of choice with the experience. Thank you.
That's a very elegant talk, Dr. Abhay. I would like to ask you, what is your current take in a patient who doesn't have...
We have been doing this even before the guidelines and the objective. Our reasons were our patients, though Dubai is rich, they do not get second chance. Then by investing 5-10 minutes more, you are able to do the procedure fast with your experience. Our door to needle time is less than 30 minutes. All our patients, the moment we see AC lesion myocardial infarction, we are able to do the procedure within 30 minutes. And we do all the vessel, infarct vessel as well as non-infarct related. We were worried before because it was against the guidelines. And if we had complication, we could be subjected to inquiry from the government. Now with these two, we are very safe.
But
I have not left a single patient and not
thrombolysis. But these two trials are trials less than 1,000 patients in total.
Yeah, four.
So this cannot be the, you know, this cannot be a game changer against the guidelines which are on lakhs and millions of patients.
I believe that the guidelines will change.
Yeah, so unless they change, do you think this is a practice which everybody should follow? Because
it's not a
big deal to get them next time, or if you wait for a few days and pre-hospital you discharge, you can do the second procedure.
These two trials, other is our experience in our
I think Abhay, there's a lot of thing to be taken with a pinch of salt, because the guidelines, in spite of these two trials being there, they haven't been modified. The Europeans have only gone down to say that if it's not a 2A indication, it's a 2B indication, that if it is possible to perform the non-culprit in an easy manner, as you said, if you're going to spend just 5-10 minutes more, but if you're going to have a problematic second vessel, you have a CTO in the second vessel, you don't do it then.
You have to individualize the
patient. Sure. So that's the.
If you have a CTO which is going to take more time in AI, you will not do it. The guidelines gives guides. It doesn't give you this. And your experience, your patient requirement is equally important.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Professor Pandey.